ओ वैष्णव गोसाई प्लीज बी मर्सीफुल टू मी नाउ देयर इज नो वन एक्सेप्ट यू हु कैन प्यूरिफाई द फॉलन सोल्स वेयर कैन एनी वन फाइंड सच ए मर्सीफुल पर्सनालिटी बाई हुज मेयर ऑडियंस सेंस ऑल सिंस गो फार अवे आफ्टर बेदिंग इन द वाटर ऑफ द सेक्रेड गंजेस मेनी टाइम्स वन बिकम्स प्यूरिफाइड बट जस्ट बाई द साइट ऑफ यू The fallen souls are purified. This is your great power. The holy name delivers one who has committed an offense to Lord Hari. But if one commits an offense to you, there is no means of deliverance. Your heart is always the resting place of Lord Govinda. And Lord Govinda says, the Vaishnavas are in my heart. Desire the dust of your holy feet. In every birth, I may take holy birth. Please consider Narottama Das yours and be kind of me. Okay. So first we will discuss the Bhagavatam Sloka, then we will briefly discuss about Baladevi Devasan and Ganga Mata Goswami. Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th Canto, Chapter 9, Mother Yashoda binds Lord Krishna, Text 5. Tam ankam arudham apayayat stanam Sneha snutam sasmitam ikhyati mukham अतृप्तम उत्सृज्य जवेन सायया उत्सिच्यमाने पयसी तु अधिश्रिते Word meaning, tam unto Krishna, ankam arudham, very affectionately allowing him to sit down on her lap, apayayat, allowed to drink, stanam, her breast, sneha snutam, which was flowing with milk because of intense affection. Sasmitam ikhyeti mukham. Mother Yashoda was smiling and observing this smiling face of Krishna. Atriptam. Krishna, who was still not fully satisfied by drinking the milk, utsijya, putting him aside, javena, very hastily, sa, Mother Yashoda, yayao, left that place, utsit, Chyamane payasi. Because of seeing that the milk was overflowing. But adhisrite in the milk pan on the oven. Translation and purport by Divine Grace अभय चरण अरविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की ट्रांसलेशन मदर जसोदा देन एम्ब्रेस्ड कृष्ण अलाउड हिम टू सिट डाउन ऑन हर लैप एंड बिगन टू लुक अपन द फेस ऑफ the Lord with great love and affection. Because of her intense affection, milk was flowing from her breast. But when she saw that the milk pan on the oven was boiling over, she immediately left her son to take care of the overflowing milk. Although the child was not yet fully satisfied with drinking the milk of his mother's breast. Purport. Everything in household affairs of Mother Yashoda was meant for Krishna. Although Krishna was drinking the breast milk of Mother Yashoda, when she saw that the milk pan on the kitchen was overflowing, she had to take care of it immediately, and thus she left her son, who then became very angry, not having been fully satisfied with drinking the milk of her breast. Sometimes one must take care of more than one items of important business for the same purpose. Therefore, Mother Yashoda was not unjust when she left her son to take care of the overflowing milk. On the platform of love and affection, it is the duty of the devotee to do one thing first and other thing later. The proper intuition by which to do this is given by Krishna. Tesam satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam dadami buddhi yogam tam jenamam upayantite. In Krishna consciousness, everything is dynamic. Krishna guides the devotee in which to what to do and from and what to do next on the platform of absolute truth. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Guruve Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Sopadantikam Vande Aham Sri Guru Siddhuta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamsya Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunathanitam Tan Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadrutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Visakhanitamsya Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesa Sunyavadi Paschatya Desa Tarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratisai Namaha Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nanda Gopakumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesa Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneswari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataruvyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, when starting this pastimes of Mother Yashoda binds the Lord Krishna in Krishna book, Srila Prabhupada just starts the story with once upon a time. And just like here is Ekada, first verse is telling, Ekada Grihadasis, that Sukadeva Goswami is describing how one day when Mother Yashoda saw that all the maid servants were engaged in other household affairs, she personally began to churn the jal. While churning, She remembered the childish activities of Krishna, and in her own way, she composed songs and enjoyed singing herself about all these activities. So these two verses in this chapter in the beginning, and it was very nicely explained by Her Grace Devi Shakti Mataji, and she gave the entire summary of the chapter. Entire summary of the chapter. And so here, that is the particular, this day was Deepavali. Diwali, very famous day in India, that Ramachandra entered Ayodhya on that particular day after killing Ravana. And he returned to Ayodhya back on this particular day, and it's very famous festivals day in India. So anyhow, on that particular day, this pastimes also happened. Because next day was Indra Puja. Later on it became Govardhan Puja. But first that time, the Brajavasis were also preparing for that puja next day. So Mother Jasoda was very busy, but still she engaged her all other maid servants in other household affairs, household activities. But she was thinking, I must personally churn butter prepare butter for my churn the curd and prepare butter for my son. This Krishna or Kanhaiya, because he is going to other house. Every day I am getting one complaint that your son come to our house and stealing butter. So butter thief, he was famous as butter thief in Braja. So Mother Jasoda thinking, this my maid servants are not so qualified. They are not so intense love for Krishna. So they are not preparing so nicely. It is not so tasty, so sweet. That's why my son is going to other house. So she decided to prepare herself this butter or makhan. So on the Deepavali day, very early morning, Krishna was still sleeping. Both mother and son, they are sleeping together, but Mother Jasoda got up earlier and she saw that Krishna is still sleeping. So then she was very carefully just got up and make her separate from Krishna, and she came to the spot where there is a pot of curd. Then she put the churning rod and with ropes she started churning the curd. So when she was churning, as Yashodhya Goswami is telling, she was also singing. She composed many songs of Krishna's childhood activities. Jani 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 Hagitani. She just accompanied very nice pastimes of Krishna, how Krishna appeared in Nanda Bhavan house, Nanda Maharaj performed the Nanda Utsav, how Putana was killed, Laitvanavarta Ghat, like this. She made very nice songs and singing. When Jasoda started singing very beautifully and also sometimes thinking within Krishna and also churning the curd, then hearing the song, because Krishna is there, where Krishna? Nahang tishtami vaikunthe yoginang hrudayena cha madbhakta jatra gayanti tatra tishtha minarada. Because Mother Jasoda started singing the pastimes of Krishna, very nice. So Krishna immediately woke up. He wanted to come to this spot. Though he was hearing, Krishna was hearing this songs of Mother Jasoda, but outwardly he was coming as if he became very hungry. Krishna was also feeling, after get up from the bed, feel hunger. Then he come to this spot. And it is mentioned that he strongly hold this churning rod. that with full force that Mother Yashoda could not churn the butter. He must stop having all activities and come to her son and attend her son. Jai Shri Shri Gaumita Ki Jai, Krishna Balaram Ki Jai. So seeing that Krishna was holding very strong the churning rod directly, strongly, Mother Yashoda smiled. She thought, my child is now become very intelligent. She knows how to stop my work. So Mother Yashoda sat down and took the child or took Krishna to her lap and started feeding her breast milk to Krishna. And then when when Krishna was sucking her milk, while Mother Yashoda was churning butter, Lord Krishna, desiring to drink the milk of her breast, approached her. And in order to increase her transcendental pleasure, he caught hold of the churning rod and began to prevent her from churning. Then Mother Yashoda, then today's verse is telling, that Mother Yashoda then embraced Krishna, allowed him to sit down on her neck and began to look upon the face of the Lord with great love and affection. Because of her intense affection, milk was flowing from her breast. But when she saw that the milk pan on the oven was boiling over, she immediately left her son to take care of the overflowing milk. Although the child was not yet fully satisfied with drinking the milk of his mother's breast. So now Yashoda sat down and allowed Krishna to sit down on her lap. And then Krishna started drinking milk from her breast. So because Mother Yashoda was intense affection, sneha, affection for Krishna, so milk was flowing from her breast. Automatically. And so Krishna was, Mother Yashoda was looking the beautiful face of Krishna. Kandarpa koti kamaniya visesha shobham. So beautiful face of Krishna also. Same time she also seeing the small, small teeth. Krishna also smiling. Krishna also drinking milk. All same time she, Krishna is also looking at mother's face and also smiling. So Krishna, Yashoda was very very pleased and with Krishna. And both mother and son, they are enjoying the transcendental bliss. But in the same time, Mother Yashoda, he saw that in the other's room, there was a milk pan on the oven. Milk was boiling over. He saw that the milk was boiling over. But why milk is boiling over? Yesterday Shankaradari Prabhu was little mentioning about how because the milk was thinking that Krishna is now sucking the milk, continuing drinking the milk from the Yashoda's breast, then what is the use of my life? Then Krishna is going and sucking the milk and full belly, then who I cannot be come in service of Krishna. Because in spiritual world everything is conscious. So here Acharya's told that how actually Krishna himself from within giving inspiration to Mother Yashoda to go and save the milk. Because when this milk was thinking, this is the whose name, when we chanted the name of Krishna, when you chant Mahamantra or chant names of Krishna, then all the conditioned souls are delivered, all their problems solved, everything solved. But even the same Lord is personally here, present, and I am just burning in this heat. I'm just it is a hot fire, and still he has no compassion for me. Then what is the value of this my life? I am not in service of Krishna, so better to jump into the fire, jump into the fire and commit suicide. Who was thinking? The milk. So actually this was mentioned in Ananda Vrindavana Champu by Kavi Karna Puru Thakur. He wrote this. It is also mentioned by another commentator like Harishwari. This commentary is not in Vishnudas Chakravarti Thakur or Sanatana Goswami. This is from other place. So this is in Ananda Vrindavana Champu also, Kavi Karna Puru Thakur mentioning this. So anyhow, so the milk, when thinking like this about Krishna is so not showing mercy to me, so Krishna just from within gave intelligence to Mother Yashoda. Just Prabhupada is quoted here, Tesam satat yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam dadami buddhi yogamutam jenamam payantiti. So Krishna, everything is dynamic. Krishna guides the devotee in what to do first and what to do next on the platform of absolute truth. So now Mother Yashoda saw in the other room the milk is boiling, is overflowing. So Mother Yashoda immediately got the intelligence by Krishna what to do. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hruddeshe arjuna tishtati. So he is there and he also guides the devotee accordingly, according to the proper situation. So it is Krishna himself, indirectly indicating Mother Yashoda to go there and save the milk. So Mother Yashoda also saw that this milk is also from Krishna. This milk in the oven, this is also for Krishna. And my breast milk, though Krishna is sucking, but later on I can feed Krishna. This is there, it cannot be wasted. But if you will not go to save that milk in oven, then it will be wasted. It's just overflow. And there is a thick layer of malai, or this thick layer of cream is there, and that will be also lost. So this is all for Krishna. Sometimes Krishna, if Prabhupada is writing that sometimes for less, the same importance of type, the two work. But Krishna gave intelligence to the devotee, what to do first and what to do later. So Mother Yashoda thought, I must go and save the milk. Then Mother Yashoda just put Krishna aside and ran to save the milk to the other room. So though Krishna was giving, in the same time Krishna also outwardly became angry because he was not fully satisfied. Krishna was fully not satisfied. Child was not yet fully satisfied with drinking the milk of his mother's breast. Not fully satisfied. So Krishna became a little angry. Then he cut his lip with his teeth. So the acharya told that actually the teeth is red, and this is this lip is red and teeth is white. This is rajaguna and this is sattaguna. If we want to control the rajaguna, then he has to press with sattaguna. Krishna just with his teeth he cut the lip. But Mother Yashoda went to the other room and just took the milk pot from oven and put it down. So so that's why Acharya is explaining like this, that why Mother Yashoda acting in that way, though Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, himself is there as her son, and still Mother Yashoda neglected. Actually, वो रागानुगो भक्त दिस इज एक्चुअली रागात्मिका भक्त इज मदर जसोदा सो देर इटर्नल रिलेशनशिप्स ऑफ कृष्ण दे डोंट कंसिडर कृष्ण एज दिस एज द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड. प्रभुपाद ऑल्सो यूज टू से वी लव कृष्ण सिंपली वी मस्ट लिव लव कृष्ण सिंपली बिकॉज सो ब्यूटिफुल एज ए ब्यूटिफुल बॉय वी डोंट केयर वेदर इज गॉड और नॉट. सो दैट इज राग दिस इज रागानुगो भक्ति. सो दैट्स वाई इन चैतन्य चैतन्यमृत ऑल्सो चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोल्ड हाँ ए विधि भक्त ही कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द ब्रज पास्ट टाइम्स सकल जगत मरे करे विधि भक्ति विधि भक्ते ब्रजभाव पाइते नाही शक्ति. चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोलिंग एंटायर वर्ल्ड इज परफॉर्मिंग एवरी वन इज परफॉर्मिंग दिस विधि भक्ति बट विधि भक्ति हैज नॉट द पावर टू अंडरस्टैंड दि ब्रज प्रेम अज ब्रज ब्रज लीलाज ऑफ कृष्ण ब्रज पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ कृष्ण. देन ही टोल्ड रागानुगो भावे भावे ब्रजे जेकरे भजन से ही जन ब्रजे पाए ब्रजेन्द्र नंदन. इफ समवन फॉलोइंग दि फुट स्टेप्स ऑफ दि रागात्मिका भक्तस लाइक मदर जसोदा एंड अदर दि गोपी देन परफॉर्मिंग दि रागानुगो फॉलोइंग देयर फुट स्टेप्स देन इन ब्रज वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड दि पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ कृष्ण. सो वी सी दैट इन दिस वे हियर मदर जसोदा इज इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्स शी जस्ट लेफ्ट हर जर्नी एंड देन रन टू द अदर रूम टू सेव द मिल्क दैट इज ऑल्सो मीन फॉर कृष्ण लाइक दे इन ए हाउस मे बी वी सेम थिंग वन मे बी लविंग इज चाइल्ड सो मच बट सेम टाइम सी मे बी सी मे बी कुकिंग फॉर आर चाइल्ड बिकॉज चाइल्ड हैज टू ईट ऑल्सो द फूड और समथिंग और हियर इज दिस मिल्क. सो समटाइम्स ही नेग्लेक्ट व्हेन हिज चाइल्ड वॉज क्राइंग और शाउटिंग और नॉट जस्ट गोन का प्रिपेयरिंग द फूड दैट इज इन दैट दिस सेम फूड वॉज लेटर ऑन द चाइल्ड हैज टू टेक. सिमिलरली हिज मिल्क वॉज बॉइलिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो फॉर कृष्ण. आई सो थिंकिंग इन दिस वे दैट दिस इज ऑल्सो दिस पर्टिकुलर दिस मलाई दैट इज इन थिक लेयर ऑन बॉयल्ड मिल्क दैट इज ऑल्सो फॉर कृष्ण. सो इन दिस वे सी जस्ट लेफ्ट टू दिस स्पॉट एंड बोथ मिल्क एंड मिल्क इन द ओवन एंड ऑल्सो मिल्क इन जसोदा दे आर इन द सेम कैटेगरी सम कैटेगरी बिकॉज दे आर ट्रांसडेंटली ऑल्सो एनवियस when that milk he was transcendentally envious who the oven the milk in within the oven when within the pot and she was thinking was she has this breast milk is serving Krishna she is so fortunate so that's why he also thought what is the use of my life I am not a Krishna is not a using me not drinking me just going on drinking this mother Jasoda's breast milk so in this way yesterday also Sankaracharya Prabhu told that how this made this come she become so made the milk thought that I must commit suicide just jumping to the fire so this is the the summary of this verse and Srila Prabhupada is specifically telling that one must take care of more than one items of more important business so then Krishna gave him intelligence to do what first and what later that is mother Jasoda also get intelligence by Krishna himself so he come but at the same time Krishna for the past times also become angry little angry and then what happened next verse we'll discuss so today is also the disappearance day of Baladev Vidyabhushan and the appearance day of Vrindavan Ganga Mata Goswami so we have to speak a little about them so Baladev Vidyabhushan is considered as Prabhupada wrote, he dedicated his Bhagavad Gita as it is to Baladev Vidyabhushan. So Baladev Vidyabhushan is a commentator on Vedanta Bhashyas. He has wrote many books, but he is famous in our Gaudiya Sampradaya because he established this Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya as an authorized Sampradaya by writing commentary on Vedanta Bhashya, Vedanta Sutra. Writing on Vedanta Sutra commentary as Govinda Bhashya. Baladev Vidyabhushan was born in Odisha in Baleswar district near Khirchora Gopinath Mandir temple. Is another village he born and in a Kayastha family. So then from very childhood he was detached to the material life and he come to the Puri for studying Sanskrit, Jagannath Puri, then he becoming a Sanskrit scholar, then he started reading the other Vedic literatures and course of his traveling. Started traveling, he came to Udupi and he got initiated in that Sampradaya, Madhva Sampradaya. And actually he became a sannyasi also in Madhva Sampradaya. And he was as a Digvijayi, sannyasi, he was traveling all over India. Came to Maheshwar and in the course of traveling again he came to, I'm just going very brief, not telling his whole life. He came to Jagannath Puri and then he challenging different scholars, to argue with him about Shastra. So then he came to everyone told the name of a scholar, Radha Damodar, Pandit Radha Damodar. So actually Radha Damodar was a disciple of Nayanananda. Nayanananda was disciple of Rasikananda. Rasikananda was disciple of Shyamananda Prabhu. So in that parampara, Shyamananda parampara. So when they're discussing, then the Radha Damodar Goswami was putting his arguments on the basis of short sandarbha of Jiva Goswami. So he was very astonished. Actually, Baladev Vidyabhushan became so influenced by his arguments, he later on became his disciple. So then he read the short sandarbha of Jiva Goswami. Then he want to learn more and more on this Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy. Then Radha Damodar Goswami sent Baladev Vidyabhushan to Vrindavan to learn Bhagavatam from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. That time Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was present. So he came and he was every day hearing Bhagavatam from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And in the same time, there in Jaipur, there are some Sikh Sampradaya Vaishnavas. They are challenging to the king. The king was a follower of Gaudiya Vaishnavas, Radha Govinda Dev. But they are challenging. How you are allowing this Gaudiya Vaishnavas to worship Radha Govinda and the Govinda Dev? They are not authorized Sampradaya. There are only four Vaishnava Sampradayas are authorized. And though they are telling that we are from Madhva Sampradaya, but they are not following Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya told the Supreme is Lakshminarayan. But though he is worshipping Krishna in Udupi, but how you bring this Radharani here with Govinda Dev? These peoples are unauthorized, so you must dismiss them from service. Let allow us to serve Govinda Dev. Put Radharani somewhere. Like this, so the king was confused. Then he sent messenger to Vrindavan to come and defeat these pandits, this Sri Sampradaya pandits. So that time Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was very old. He could not walk to Jaipur from Vrindavan to. So he sent his Sikhya disciple, this Baladev Vidyabhushan. Another was also assisting him. So Baladev Vidyabhushan started walking from Vrindavan to Jaipur. But he was completely detached person. It may describe that he was only with one kaupin and with danda and kamandalu. Baladev just went to Jaipur. So when the Jaipur king saw Baladev Vidyabhushan, he told him, how this person defeat these peoples? is so learning, eh? And he is so so anyhow, there is one place called Galta. When you enter Jaipur from Mathura road, you go to Jaipur, then first we have entered the Galta. One first enter Jaipur, eh? That is Galta. There is, now there is also some mountains surrounding, and there is the place where Galavrushi, apart from meditation, and again there is Ganga just coming, and then again manifested there from earth. And that place actually is Galta. There is the argument. This Pandit Sabha was arranged by the king, and Sri Sampradaya's Pandits are sitting there. Then he, Baladeva Vidyabhushan, appeared. King was thinking this man will definitely be defeated, will get defeated by these Pandits. But these Pandits were very fearful. When they saw Baladeva Vidyabhushan, they understood he is the same person. He was before in Madhya Madhava Sampradaya and with a sannyasi. And how he come to this Gaudiya Vaishnavas? So he is Digvijay Pandit. So anyhow, Baladeva Vidyabhushan defeat them by argument, logic, and by they cannot come in front of Baladeva Vidyabhushan. Finally they told, okay, we don't understand anything, but we want to see the Vedanta Bhashya. Where is your commentary on Vedanta Bhashya? If a Sampradaya has no commentary on Vedanta Bhashya, then it is not considered as not on Vedanta Sutra, no Bhashya on Vedanta Sutra. So you must show us a commentary on Vedanta Sutra. Acharya must comment on Vedanta Sutra, on Bhagavad Gita, on 10 Upanishads, and also now we go to Sampradaya Bhagavatam. So anyhow, so he told, you have no commentary on Vedanta Sutra. So Baladeva Vidyabhushan told, because Srimad Bhagavatam is the natural commentary, Bhashyayam Vedanta Brahma Sutranam, this is the Bhashya, this is Bhagavatam, that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told. So that we don't need any other Bhashya of the Vedanta Sutra. The author, Vyasadeva himself, but they did not accept this. He told, no, you have to show us the commentary. So Baladeva Vidyabhushan just come to the shelter of Govinda Dev, Radha Govinda temple, and just he fasted for many days, just praying to Govinda Dev, you have to save your Sampradaya. You are Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you come, and how, why you are doing this, all these things are happening. So finally Govinda Dev came in dream and told him, you just hold paper and pen, you hold a pen, whatever to write, I have to write everything. Just are you inspired with everything, you write. It will be definitely accepted by everyone. So now he is convinced, and Baladeva Vidyabhushan started this wonderful commentary, that is on a Vedanta Sutra, that is Govinda Bhashya. It is famous because Govinda Dev himself inspired Baladeva Vidyabhushan to write this Bhashya. He was just like Prabhupada told that Krishna was prompting, I was writing. So yes, Govinda Dev was prompting and Baladeva Vidyabhushan was writing this Vedanta Sutra, this commentary. So within 7 days he prepared the Vedanta commentary on Vedanta Sutra, prepared on the Bhashya, on Bhagavad Gita, that is Gita Abhushana Bhashya. Prabhupada in Bhagavad Gita as it is, he took about 70% from that Gita, that commentary of Baladeva Vidyabhushan. So then he wrote his the commentary on 10 Upanishads, then he brought everything and sort of to the Pandits. And there is the Pandits here. When they saw this Govinda Bhashya, they were completely amazed. He told, it is not the work of a human being. He definitely, Govinda Dev, helping this guy. So in this way, everyone accepted this commentary. This is the best commentary. Everyone, they gave the recommendation that, though there is other commentaries of the Acharya, Ramanuja Acharya, Sri Sampradaya, Ramanuja Acharya wrote commentary on Vedanta Sutra, Madhava Acharya, and Nimbarka and Vishnu Swami. But this commentary, this Govinda Bhashya, this commentary by Baladeva Vidyabhushan is definitely best of all of the commentaries. So in this way we say how Baladev Vidyabhusan was being specially favored by Govinda Dev. He wrote this commentary and saved this sampradaya. He wrote many books, many other books. He was a great scholar. And then our Gaudiya sampradaya was considered everyone as a authorized sampradaya. So that's why Baladev Vidyabhusan has a special position in our sampradaya. And he came back to Vrindavan and Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur and all Vaishnava Gaudiya Vaishnava become very happy. And then he engaged in service of Radha Shyama Sundara. Radha Shyama Sundara temple in, you can see that is the big deities of Radha Shyama Sundara is also established by Baladev Vidyabhusan and he started worshipping them. The small deity, that is Shyamananda Prabhu's deity, Radha Shyama Sundara small deities. So I very briefly narrated this, then again we have to speak about Ganga Mata Goswamini. So Ganga Mata Goswamini was a princess, daughter of a king in Kutia, small kingdom called Kutia in Bengal, West Bengal side. Now it is in Assam, part of Assam. So, and Naresh Narayan was his father, and she was the only daughter. From her early age, she was a great devotee of Krishna. She was always playing with Krishna's deities. And she refused to his parents. He told his parents, I am not going to get married. My Krishna is my husband. I don't consider anyone in this material world having this, having a material body, and then I can become husband. Only Krishna is the husband of all living entities. So in this way she rejected everyone and accepted Krishna as her husband. And so her parents were died in time, and then she became the ruler of the kingdom, and for few years she also ruled the kingdom successfully, and finally she developed attachment for Krishna and his pastime places. This Vrindavan she came to see, Vrindavan, with a group of other his maid servants, other ladies. She came to Vrindavan, and in Vrindavan she was searching for a spiritual master. Someone, she knows that unless one accepts a spiritual master, there is no spiritual life. So she was searching for a spiritual master, and he heard from other Vaishnavas that just like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is telling that Pandita Gosai Re Shishya Ananta Acharya Tahara Priya Shishya Pandita Haridas. Pandita Haridas, there is great Vaishnava. Ananta is from Gadadhar Pandit's parampara. Gadadhar Pandit is Ananta Acharya's disciple. Ananta Acharya's disciple was Haridas Pandit. So Haridas Pandit was, that time he was priest in Govindavi temple. And when Ganga Devi Goswami, her name was that time Sachi. Her parents were kept her name as Sachi. She approached Haridas Pandit, please accept me as your disciple, with a great humility. But Haridas Pandit told, you are a princess, how can you perform this austere life? Vaishnava life very austere. So you have to, you are a princess having so many servants, maid servants, about 20-25 servants with you. And you have so many golden opulent ornaments you are wearing and all this. This is not Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya is Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga Sikhyartham Ekam Purana Purusa Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sarira Dhari Krupam Buddhi Jaitamaham Prapadhi. Described that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is appeared to teach this Vairagya Vidya. This is like Goswami's, his principal disciples there. Kantha Kaupina Kantyektva Purna Vasesa Mandalapati Sening Sada Tuchavat Bhutva Ganesh Karunaya Kaupina Kanthasitu. So he told Haridas Pandit, you are, I cannot accept you, disciple you as princess. but she was determined to become his disciple. So Sachi, she sent all her these assistants, these servants, go back to Kutia, tell the ministers they should rule the kingdom. Don't think about that, don't wait for me. I will be here as long as my guru is not accepting me as his disciple. So she stay here and she performed extreme austerity, gave up all her costly clothes, ornaments, everything, and just doing every day Vrindavan parikrama, whenever Govardhan parikrama, and just with a simple sadhi and sleeping sometimes somewhere in the bank of Jamuna and like this. So seeing her detachment and austerity, then finally Haridas Pandit accepted her as his disciple. And then he told, when Haridas Pandit accepted a disciple, then he told, you go to Radhakund and there is another disciple of mine, Lakshmi Priya Devi, you both do bhajan there together. Then they are chanting 2 lakh names every day, 2 lakhs or more. Then one day Haridas Pandit called her and told, you go to now Jagannath Puri. So Jagannath Puri, after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's associates were disciples, no one is preaching Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy there. So it is, you should go and every day give Bhagavatam class there and preach the people about Gaudiya Vaishnava, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy. So though Sachi or great attachment with Vrindavan and but following the instructions of his, following instruction of her guru, she left Vrindavan and went to Jagannath Puri. And she, there she was staying in Sarvam Bhattacharya's house. And that is also known as Gangamata Goswami's place. So Sachi was staying there and started following the instruction of his guru, started giving Bhagavatam class every day. And many people's coming. She became gradually very famous. When people from 50 kilometers, 60 kilometers, they are coming to hearing his Bhagavatam class. So even the king, the Gajapati Raja, the king of Puri, also came, hearing about so many people, thousands of people coming to hearing Bhagavatam Katha, then king also started coming to this, her speech, to hear her Bhagavatam from Sachi Devi. So, but there is one, I am going very brief, so the Ganga Dasar, there is a Ganga special day for taking bath on Ganges. So she was thinking, I cannot go. She was inside thinking, her desire to go to take bath in Ganges, but same time was thinking, how can I disobey the orders of my guru? And he instructed me to stay in Jagannath Puri and also preach Bhagavatam. So when she was thinking in like this, disappointed, night she saw a dream. Jagannath appeared in dream. Jagannath told, why you are so morose? Here is Ganga Path, Sweta Ganga, still in Puri. You go in night, this is not different from Ganga. You can take the bath there. And you don't, do you thinking I am simply a wooden doll? Ganga is flowing from my feet. So this Sweta Ganga is real Ganga. So then midnight, you go and take bath now. So it was midnight, but because it's Jagannath instruction, so Ganga Mata Goswami came, or Sachi came, and just touching the water, then the water overflowed. It is coming like great wave, and just swept on that wave. Sachi was go away with water, just. So she was unconscious, she could not know what is happening. She saw when she in her consciousness, then she saw she was inside Jagannath temple, standing in front of Jagannath. Her temple was closed, everything was closed, but she was in front of Jagannath standing. And Jagannath was smiling, very affectionately looking at Gangamata Goswami. So at that time, her name was not like that. So anyhow, Sachi. But there is some sound coming from inside. So the chowkidars, everyone is thinking, how the sound is coming? Midnight, how, where, what happened? So they informed the king. And then the pujaris came and they opened the door inside. And went to the altar, they saw there is only, no one is there, only this Ganga Mata Goswami is standing in front of Jagannath. Of course, the tears are flowing from her eyes. But they thought this lady, somehow or other yesterday, maybe hide somewhere, herself and he come to stealing the ornaments of Jagannath. Because of Jagannath's ornament very costly, diamond, so they asking anything, Sachi not telling anything. She was simply crying and silent, deep silent. So the king thought, how I personally saw she was explaining Bhagavatam so nicely, how it is. King was in doubt. But the other minister, they forced the king, please arrest this lady. Finally, she was arrested and put in jail. Then Jagannath came in a dream to the king, chastised him like anything. This is my devotee. In this whole entire Puri, there no one is so pure. She is the best devotee. You have the proud that you are my servant, but I am instructing him. You must take initiation from this lady, this Ganga Mata Goswamini. Because from that day, Jagannath himself addressed, this is Goswamini, you should, everyone started calling her as Ganga Mata Goswamini. So king, getting the instructions from the Jagannath himself, so he begged her pardon to Sachi and accepted initiation. She was not agreed to give initiation, but because king told this Jagannath instruction, what can I do? So when king took initiation, so many other ministers, many other officials, many thousands of people that took initiation from Ganga Mata Goswami. In this way she became an acharya. Like Janhava Mata, then Ganga Mata Goswamini. So the Jagannath himself made her an acharya. So then Ganga Mata Goswami was stay in Puri and continuing in preaching. And this Shyamarai deity, that is Ganga Mata Goswami worship, that is come from Jaipur. This is a long story. There are so many other pastimes. So time is over. So I stop here. So Ganga Mata Goswami ki, Baladevi Dhyavasam ki jai, Grantra Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Mother Yashoda ki jai, Krishna Kanhaiyalal ki jai.